Okay, I'd like to call this meeting to order. Will you all rise and join us in the pledge of allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All board members, with the exception of Director Schimmick, are present. I'd like a motion to approve the agenda. Are there any changes to the agenda before we move on? Yes.
I would like to propose an addition to Section 10 New Business, Item D, which would be reviewing a recommendation from the Finance Committee for the district to consider switching carriers for the life, accidental death, and dismemberment policies, as well as our long-term disability policies.
Okay. In addition, I would like to move off the consent agenda items E and F. Youth Proclamation Week and or a proclamation for Youth Appreciation Week and a proclamation for American Education Week. With those changes, are there any objections to the changes as noted? Seeing none, all those in favor of the revised agenda signify by saying aye.
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 Did we actually get the motion?
I thought you made the motion to make the change.
I put forward the suggested change, but I don't know that the...
Then do I have a motion?
I'll put forward the change, and I'll make the motion for that revised agenda. Then.
Thank you.
And
do I have a second?
Yeah.
By Stacy. Okay, now, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? And that motion carries 6-0. On tonight's consent agenda, we have the check wire transfer disbursement summary, our bank reconciliation statements for September 2011, resignations, terminations, donations of $100 per person through the residential mortgage group program from Stacy Forst, Deb Hilmerson, and Mr. and Mrs. Todd Kamishik to Jeffers Pond Elementary. In addition, we have $500 from the Prior Lake Optimist Club for Paw Pads program at Hidden Oaks Middle School, $636 from the Prior Lake Optimist Club for the Summer Band Program, and $461 from Optimist for the Summer Swim Program. Then you'll also have the Assurance and Compliance Report, which is our routine annual report. Do I have a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved.
By Todd, second.
Second.
By Stacy. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? That motion carries 6-0. And next we have Laker Showcase.
And tonight, Laker Showcase is brought to us by Edgewood, our early childhood center, and our kindergarten program. And Principal Deb Williams is going to bring in some students to demonstrate some new equipment that they've just purchased. And the children are here to show you what happens.
Participants from Edgewood School, ranging in age from 2 to 5 and a half, would like you to show you a little bit about what 21st century learning looks like, ages 2 to 5. 21st century learning is not just about technology, it's about building kids who can exemplify teamwork, problem solving, creativity, and part of our playground really is helping them learn those skills. So they're going to show you how playground equipment that isn't attached to the ground can be used, how they can work with their friends to change or to work together with it. And if you have any questions, they'll be happy to try and answer it later. But right now, they're going to show you what kinds of things they like to do or change with their new playground equipment.
So what do we need to do? Are you going to go in the hiding spot, Sammy?
Yeah.
The beauty of this equipment is there is no one right or wrong way to use it. The kids change it daily. What they do with it changes daily. They get friends to help them change it. They suggest things to their friends of how to change it. That's the teamwork and the problem solving, the creative thinking.
So Deb.
We have a friend helping. Oh, but hang on, let's peek in the windows. Is there anybody inside?
Yeah.
Oh, and here comes Nathan. Says we don't want to go from doing. Hey, you've got some friends to help you. What are you gonna do? Turn him into a rocker? That's our little friend.
So Deb, while the children are playing, can you tell us why you chose this equipment, what the purpose of it is?
The biggest benefit of this equipment is that it does change daily, that the kids can change it themselves, doesn't rely on adults, because frankly, we are not half as creative as they are. And most of it requires them to work in a team. They want to flip something over if they want to use it. It also allows pretty much full participation of any of our special needs kids to be able to get to it, use it, on it, create with it differently. The equipment does not look the same 2 days in a row. It's always different. The kids are always inventing new ways that we never even thought that they can use it. And they're really finding out that the teamwork and the problem solving of how to make it work together is just huge. Whereas static playground equipment that's welded into the ground, there really isn't any of that imaginative play or any of that problem solving going on for the most part.
Yes.
Join me at the door.
Can you introduce the students?
I surely will. Right here. Turn around. Right here. It's all the people here. Okay. And can you make sure
you're going to be close? Deb, I think you're going to have to get over in the center, maybe.
Sam, come over.
Hi.
Say it again, Keith.
I'm Sam. I'm five.
Can you see them?
Nathan, and he is 2.5. Who's this kid?
Tyler.
And how old is Tyler?
Two.
Two. And Sam, can you introduce yourself?
Big voice.
Sam,
I'm four. And?
My name is Ryan, and I'm 5 and a half.
Well, thanks for letting us talk to you about our equipment. Do you have any questions for your boys and girls?
I'm jumping.
You're jumping. I know, it's really fun. You know what? You have to be all the time now.
Tomorrow.
But guess what? Tomorrow, it will all be back in the school hall. We're not going to let the grown-ups keep it. We're going to bring it back.
Oh, wow, man.
So they just got to see it for a tiny while.
Thanks, guys.
And as a parent, if I could just add, watching the kids now, they all, none of them go to the traditional, I shouldn't say none, but the great majority of kids are on the new equipment now, and the traditional slides and monkey bars and things are just, this stuff is just so creative and so wonderful, and it's green, totally eco, and we can, the fact that we can bring this inside and get some real great girls' motor skill movement stuff going on in the winter is fabulous. So we couldn't be more tickled as parents that Deb brought the innovation to Edgewood. So.
And just so you know, the purchasing of this was done cooperatively. The Early Childhood Advisory Council has been fundraising for several years to improve the playground. We used some ECFE funds, some ECSE special ed funds, and some state health and safety funds, and put it all together to purchase all the pieces. And there are more pieces. This is just all that would fit in the room tonight.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Keep coming.
That's very creative.
You can get 3-year-old back.
I'll just just leave it. That's. I don't think we have anything going up front anyway. You want to take? Do we need a couple of minute recess to? Okay. Next on the agenda is our open forum. This is a point in time in our meeting where we set aside 15 minutes for residents to address the board on any item not on the agenda. Is there anyone that would like to address the board this evening? Seeing no one, I'll move on to personnel items. Matt.
All right. First, I would like to recommend the following candidates for employment, and I'm seeking board approval.
Do I have a motion to approve the candidates as presented? So moved by Tom. Second.
Second.
By Todd. Any questions? Seeing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? That motion carries 6-0. Leaves of absences.
And second, I present the following leaves of absence and am seeking board approval.
Do I have a motion to approve the leave of absences as presented?
So moved.
By Rich. Second.
Second.
By Stacy. Any questions or discussion? I have one question on Marina Gross and the TBD. Is this, how long are we looking for this leave to be?
At the moment, we don't know. I would anticipate that it will be between 1 month and 3 months. But it's a medical leave request, and it'll be the speed of her recovery.
Is there any way that we could put some sort of a parameter and have it represented to the board at some point in time rather than open-ended?
Yeah, we could bring it back to the next meeting.
No, I'm saying we can approve it now for a period of time, say to the end, you know, is it possible it could go to the end of the school year?
No, it would not be possible that it would go to the end of the school year. Are you saying, would you like it to be brought back if
it
did need to be extended?
I just don't want it to go 2 years, 3 years type of thing, right? That's unfortunately.
Sure, absolutely. And for one thing, no medical leave exists beyond a year without coming back before the board.
Okay.
And so there's always a 1 year parameter on a medical leave of absence.
Well, didn't realize that. Okay.
I'm sorry. No problem. Okay. Absolutely.
Any other questions? Okay, seeing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That motion carries 6-0. Thank you. We have no old business. We'll move on to new business, which is board goals. What we shared with you earlier in the week for comment and review was the proposed board goals for 2011-2012. And
It's been quite a job. I think we've probably put more work into evaluating our goals and aligning our goals this year with the administrative team than we ever have in the past. And I think it's been a very good process. And as we talked about it on Monday with Lee and Suzanne, what I liked about the process was the ideas came through the administration. We did some prioritizing, some theming to decide what was important for us as a district as a whole to set that umbrella vision, that direction that now can be pushed down to the superintendent and the rest of the administrative team as far as how to achieve those goals. It's probably the first time since I've been on the board that we've truly aligned our goals specifically with the strategic vision or strategic plan. And I think it was well worth the effort to do so, because I think we as a board now are on the same vision, the same track as the administrative team, who's been setting their goals based on a strategic plan for several years. Mm-hmm. You have anything you want to add?
I really appreciate the collaborative approach of looking at where we want to be. We stretched out 2 years and then came back to this year. And I appreciated the time that we took to talk about those themes and what's important and what's the board's governance role in getting the work done that we think is so important to our organization. So I believe these goals are really very strong in their essence of moving this organization to that next level of excellence. So I'm very proud of the work you've done. It's great.
So with that, before I open up for questions and discussion, do I have a motion to approve the 2011-12 board goals as presented?
So moved.
By Mike, second?
Second.
By Todd. Any questions, comments, discussion? None?
I'll echo the comments. I mean, I think these are more substantive, but they're also more in alignment with what the mission of the board really should be, as opposed to, some of the goals we've had in the past without really being critical of that. And I think, obviously, the conversations that we've had, like any other organization, there's always way more things that you'd love to do than you have time or capacity to do. So I think it's good that we had the conversation, and then we kind of look back and said, what's realistic to accomplish, but then also what's really the priorities. Mm-hmm. And so I'm pleased that we've had that conversation, and I think this is a good starting point for not only this board, but boards of the future to really kind of build upon.
Anything else? Seeing none, I'll take. We have a motion and a second. All those in favor of adopting this year's board goals, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? That motion carries 6-0. Then next we have superintendent goals. Sue Ann.
And my goals are on page 23, and then continue on through page 24. Again, we worked collaboratively with the board. We talked about where we've been, our successes, our areas of challenge, and where it is we'd like to be in the future in 2013. And then we backed it up to what could we accomplish in this given year. And so my goals are aligned to the board goals and reflect the actions and the work that needs to happen administratively in order to accomplish our vision for where we want to be by the end of this school year. So I again am very proud of the work that we've done together, and know that the work here is just one soundbite of the kinds of detail that will be happening across the district at each of our sites, at each of our levels, from early childhood through 12th grade, to be able to accomplish our strategic directions.
Okay, do I have a motion to approve the superintendent goals as presented?
So moved.
By Todd, second?
Second.
By Tom. Any questions or discussion?
If no one else has.
Yeah, go ahead.
Not that I want to be the only one speaking, but within the first page of Dr. Groover's goals, I think the bullet point that really
resonates with me is the fourth one on there that talks to working collaboratively with the school board and administration to make the Prior Lake Savage Area Schools known statewide as a school district of excellence. And I think that is something that, you know, oftentimes when we're in our workshops, the public doesn't get to hear, right, you know, a lot of the discussions and conversation that we had. And you know, I'll maybe speak on behalf of the entire board, but I got the sense of our conversations that that is a goal that we all share in common, that everybody was in support, and that desire to really be known as, you know, a district that people moving into the state, that they'll say, that's a place that I may want to consider moving because it's a place where my kids are going to get a great education. And I think it was a personal point of pride that all of us, the board, administration, everybody really wants to see us taking continuing efforts. I think we already work very, very hard to make that a case, and all we're really saying is maintaining those things and then obviously letting people know, you know, we're a great secret. I think we talked about we want to be the district that south of the river is seen as the shining star. And I think those are really great, great things that we should be achieving and striving for.
You know, we talked about it the other night while setting the agenda. I think this is probably the most comprehensive view of what the superintendent does that we've probably ever had. When I look at the first column, goals on you know, being the best superintendent as defined by the role of superintendent, that we have. What do we have strategic that we're going to accomplish this year, and then what are we looking for in the future? And I think that ties in very well with what we've done both financially with the two-year plan, what we've talked about with a forward-looking operational plan. So we're not operating in the current year alone, but we always know what's being researched and what's, you know, what's going to be the theme for the coming year. Allows, I just think it's again, it may not seem like it to a lot of people, but this is between the three documents that we're going to talk about this evening, the board goals being aligned to what administration's doing, and to the strategic plan, this, which gives us goals across the superintendent's entire realm of responsibility for the first time ever. And then what we'll see coming up as far as a plan, we're late into the year in getting this, but it was, you know, it was months of work and investment well spent. So with that, all those in favor of adopting the superintendent's goals signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That motion carries 6-0. And so next we have the operations plan.
Right, and the operational plan is a two-year look, a two-year view of the kinds of themes, the work that we're going to be doing together, again, collaboratively, the school board, myself, our administration, our classroom teachers, our paraprofessionals, all of us throughout the district working together to accomplish this plan over the course of the next 2 years. So this is an 11-12 and a 12-13 operational plan. And it is here tonight after much review by the board and conversation dialogue about where we want to be by the end of 2013.
Okay. Now, I think as we talked, this was more of an adoption rather than an approval, right, of.
This is a living document. I like to say that means it could change very easily given anything happening in our organization, in our community, or in our state, or in the United States or the world. So this is where we believe we're going to be in 2012-13, but that will be up for adoption next fall when we look at this again. We'll probably be bringing it back to you earlier next year because we've gone through this very lengthy involved process of beginning this dialogue early and continuing until we all felt comfortable that we were at a place and time that we were really defining our truth of where we are and where we want to be. So this will come back again, but this is just as a component of the package.
And this is more of a, I think as we discussed it, correct me if I'm wrong, this was more of a management document, mm-hmm, than it was truly a strategic board document. How the administration was going, mm-hmm, to accomplish the goals that you and we have set together. So with that, I will take a motion to accept the operations plan.
So moved. By Todd, second by Stacy. Any questions or discussion? I should have asked for that ahead of time.
I think it's very good.
Yes.
Just to build on the comment that I made with respect to Dr. Gruber's goals for the school year, the operational plan now quantifies some of those things as we talked about, what we look and see the our school district striving for excellence. And so I really am very pleased to see that there's both a quantitative and qualitative aspect to the plan and what we're expecting, specifically when we're talking about, you know, increasing student achievement in our math, reading, science by 2 percentage points, and a goal, a target out there of being the best in the South Suburban Conference. So we want to be the, you know, the district that the rest of the districts in the conference would say, you know, they're the ones at the top that we need to get better at. And then for next year, recognizing again as we want to look at being the best or one of the best in the state, saying, you know, it's great to be at the top of the South Suburban Conference, but we also have some other school districts that I know in your tenure, Sue Ann, you have been comparing as we look at our test results, you know, the Wayzatas and the Eden Prairies and the Edinas. And so I think that's a great thing also for us to say, you know, we need to be benchmarking and setting ourselves, you know, what's the standard that we want to, you know, compare to. Right. So I appreciate and I applaud both you and the entire administrative staff for setting those plans in place.
Thank you.
Anything else? Okay. Seeing no other comments, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? And that motion is accepted, 6-0. Next on the agenda, I lost my space here.
Yes.
Oh, here we go. We have the considered new insurance carriers.
Good evening. Actually, it's interesting that we just went through our operational plan because on there we are looking for efficiencies and fixed costs as a district, and this is one of the areas that we're looking for efficiencies. We actually went received some quotes from different vendors for our life, long-term disability, and accidental death and dismemberment. And so in reviewing this and looking through the different vendors that offer proposals to the district, we did come up with one company that gave us a really good option of saving approximately $228,000 a year. And it's a significant amount of money that we looked at. What we are doing is there's really no change, and we asked them to make a like-for-like proposal from what we currently have to what they're offering us. And the proposals are very similar. There is only one change, and that's in the elimination period for our long-term disability. It's going from 21 working days to 30 calendar days, which is essentially the same amount, and 30 calendar days, they include the weekends, whereas in working days, they do not. So in essence, it's the same amount of time. So it's really a no change in our what we currently offer for a long-term disability, life, and accidental death and dismemberment. The options, we are saving quite a bit of money. And in addition to that, for our employees, we will offer an option for a supplemental life plan that's a lower rate, and it incrementally increases as the person is older. But it starts off at a very low rate when they're younger. And so right now we just currently have one rate for all our employees. And so our employees will have the option to utilize that supplemental insurance for any additional insurance they want for themselves or for their family. But the district will continue to pay and offer the same plan that we currently have now as well. But I think it's a really good opportunity to look at these fixed costs, to come to the board and say that yes, we're looking at them, finding ways that we can save money for the district and our employees in the long run.
It's a non-action item tonight, so if anybody has any questions. Oh, sorry, Tom.
I used to as an insurance company are rated fairly high, correct?
I mean, yes, ING is rated very high.
Okay.
Yes, we only went with those companies that had similar to what we are, our company that we currently have now.
Sorry.
No. And I, at our finance committee meeting, you were saying that we don't have a high percentage of our staff that take advantage of this, and by having lower rates, we might get more participation.
That's correct. Because our supplemental life is at a higher rate right now, because it's the same rate for no matter how old you are, we don't have a lot of our employees take any supplemental life for themselves or for their spouses or children. And this way, if they start when they're younger, it's a very low rate, much lower. It's a save about 30 cents on $1,000 for the employee if they start in their early 20s when they first are employed in the district. And so it is very economical for them. And as they get older, that rate does increase, but it's not until they reach the age of 55 that they would even reach what they are currently, that we're currently at this time. So it's a really good option for our employees as well.
Okay. We talked to Finance Committee. We're going to be meeting with Meet and Confer on Wednesday and be able to present it to that group. Deb Johnson sat in Finance Committee today and got an overview of the program, so we were able to get at least her feedback and perspective early on through this process to make sure that she didn't see any concerns as, you know, as a potential consumer of the program. So far, you know, it looks like a win for the district overall.
Now we'll bring this back for approval at the November 14th board meeting.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yep. Oh, man, that was loud. next, we have the proclamation for Youth Appreciation Week. And I'll read the proclamation, whereas the vast majority of youth are concerned, knowledgeable, and contributing partners within the community, and whereas accomplishments and achievement of these young citizens deserves the recognition and praise of the community, and whereas Optimist International has, since 1954, developed and promoted a program entitled Youth Appreciation Week, and whereas the citizens of Prior Lake Savage Area School District have indicated a desire to join the Optimist in expressing appreciation and approval for the contributions of youth, the District 719 Board of Education does hereby proclaim the third week of November as Youth Appreciation Week in the district. By this action, let it be known that we have faith in the ability of today's youth as they assume responsible roles in the future of humankind. Do I have a motion to approve Youth Appreciation Week proclamation as presented?
So moved.
By Stacy. Second?
Second.
By Tom. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? And that motion carries 6-0.
And I might add,
yes,
that the Optimist Club annually recognizes 30 students across our community for their contributions in upholding the dignity of youth and showing sincere devotion to the welfare of others. And that celebration will be held this on Wednesday, November 16th, at 11:30 at Fong's Restaurant. And I know in your board packet it says that it's at Archangel Hall, and I just received an email in the last couple of days saying that it has been moved to Fong's. So it will be at Fong's, and the board members are all invited to attend. It's really a wonderful event, and one that we can be holding with great pride of the students that we have in our system that are really making a difference in their communities and in their schools. So I always look forward to this particular luncheon that we have to recognize our students.
Next, we have a proclamation that we do recognizing American Education Week. And that proclamation would be, whereas public schools are the backbone of our democracy, providing young people with the tools they need to maintain our nation's precious values of freedom, civility, and equality. And whereas by equipping young Americans with both practical skills and broader intellectual abilities, schools give them hope for and access to a productive future. And whereas education employees, be they custodians or teachers, administrators or clerical staff, bus drivers or librarians, cooks or support staff, they work tirelessly to serve our children and communities with the care and professionalism. And whereas our district, the community hub for bringing together adults and children, educators and volunteers, business leaders and elected officials in a common enterprise,
Now, therefore, the Prior Lake Savage Area School Board of Education does hereby proclaim November 14th through 18th as the 90th observance of American Education Week. Do I have a motion to approve the proclamation as written?
So moved.
I'm sorry, by Todd, second?
Second.
By Stacy. Any comments, questions? You know, I think it's, you know, it's interesting these come at the same time. One, recognizing the people who help our kids see a bright future, and recognizing that we are preparing our students to assume responsibility for not only this country and this community, but the world in general. And I couldn't be more proud of the students that we're sending for, students like Chris, or the people that are helping them achieve their high potential. So with that, I'll take we have a motion and a second. I'm sorry, did you have a comment?
Just that I agree with you. The recognizing students and teachers on the same night is really a beautiful marriage of the two, because we have great students and families in our district. And I've been in many of the classrooms recently and continue to have a schedule of being in them regularly. And what I see is just outstanding teaching going on. And I'm very proud of the work that our teachers are doing on a daily basis, on an hourly basis, as they usher in new students and really give them that quality of education that we're so proud of here in Prairie Lake Savage Area Schools. So congratulations to our students and congratulations to our teachers as we recognize you in November.
Okay, with that, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That motion carries 6-0. Board members, please make sure you contact Martha with your schedule. We typically try to spend at least one day in the schools that we represent in order to convey the board's appreciation back to staff. Next, we have first reading of policies. Let's start with 807, naming of school buildings.
Yes. This is a policy that we brought back for bit of review, not a whole lot, but enough that we're not naming any new buildings at this time. It's always good to look at the wording in our policies to make sure that, first of all, that the positions that we reference are in existence, or that there are any changes. And you can see under Roman numeral 3, general statement of policy, we've gone from a communications specialist to a communications coordinator, who is Christy Musman. And we wanted to reflect that change to make sure that we're in keeping with our policy. So that's a minor change, but a significant one. And then toward the end of that policy, you can see that we've referenced other policies when we're talking about gift giving, major gifts, donations of gifts, and memorials for deceased students. And are those the same policy number, Martha? We have the same policy.
The memorials one should be 531.
531. So on the second page, which is page 27 of your packet, the second should be changed to 531.
Yeah. Okay. Any comments or discussion on the policy 807? Okay, seeing none, if you do think of anything afterwards, please contact Sue Ann or the Policy mm-hmm. Committee. And we can move on to 610 field trips.
This has got to be my very favorite policy because I bring it back every single year, sometimes twice a year. But this year, we do have some changes to it that I think are really positive changes that will help us as we move forward to be really clear on what our expectations are for major magnitude field trips and the responsibilities of oversight. So as you look at it on the first page, under Roman numerals 2 and then item C, major magnitude trips, it says that a trip request must be completed and approved by the principal, superintendent, and or designee rather than the school board. So we're looking at major magnitude field trips in a different way. Yes, the oversight is still as stringent, and we will continue to look at not only how we prepare for our major magnitude field trips, but also how we follow up with them. What happens after a field trip? What kind of follow-up should we have, and when should it come to the school board? So that is all taken care of in these revisions that you see here. I can go through the individual changes if you would like, but I could also ask, you know, as you go through these, as you see that theme, are there questions that the board has as you've read through this policy? I don't care.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's just consistent with what we talked about a few months ago, that, you know, in conjunction with us looking at board governance versus other things, and I think this was one good example where we said, you know, it really should be, you know, Dr. Gruber, you in the role of the superintendent working with the building principals to say this is or is not within the scope of the educational objective, and if you feel it's that way, you know, I think we as a board need to have the confidence that you're making the best decisions, and, you know, I fully support, and I'm excited to see that this has been through the policy committee, and obviously Stacy Lee's not here, but I'm assuming you, obviously you're in support of it as well.
Yes. We had lengthy discussion just as to, you know, what our role is and Sue Ann's, and really felt comfortable having her, you know, be the, you know, the final say, you know, and here in number four, we just said any exception to these procedures listed above will require school board approval. So if anything falls out of those parameters, then it should come before us. So, yeah, I mean, I think I've actually seen this twice, considering I've only been on the policy for 9 months. But and some of these things we put in that we've already, like under number four, under B, the multiple bids. I mean, that's, we've already kind of done that as part of our procedure. So a lot of this was just matching what we've had, you know, had been doing. So.
Well, just to echo what Mike said, I mean, you know, as we talked about it, putting together. And I think you made the link first, putting together what we're talking about is what's our role as a board and oversight and setting the parameters versus getting into some of the routine types of things when we see some of the same major magnitude field trips come through each and every year. We set the parameters through, you know, through our policy, just like we do any other decision that gets made.
Right.
That we trust the administration to act within policy. So I think this is wholly consistent with what we've done. I like the fact that we've left the option to bring back some of the more interesting trips for presentation back to the board, because I think it does a couple of things. One, it highlights the fact that we are doing some really great things that are broadening the perspective of our students and getting a chance to celebrate those successes outside of kind of the normal parameter. And I like that we were able to maintain the exemption for Wolfridge as a very structured program that would operate under its own set of very confined rules. So any other comments or questions? Great. This will come back next meeting as a second reading as well. So again, if there's any thoughts that you have afterwards, please contact superintendent or policy committee. Next, we have the superintendent's report.
I actually came up so quickly. Get out my notes so I can remember all the good things that are happening here. It's been a busy couple of weeks. We've had parent conferences, and it's been very interesting to hear the feedback as principals and teachers have finished up with those conferences and the parent feedback on them. The participation certainly is different at every level, but parents have access to our teachers, and Deb Johnson and I were just talking about this, 24/7 now that they can be electronically communicating through the internet, and certainly at the high school we see that. But we also see and maximize those opportunities that parents have to come in and visit in person when they need to do that also. So one doesn't take away the other, but certainly it makes a difference in how we participate at different levels. So that certainly has been going on. Just this, in the last couple of days, that 1 minute vignette of our video of our district, our marketing video, has been placed on our YouTube channel, ISD 719. So remember, we had the longer version, the 9 minute, well, we've reduced it now to the 1 minute. The longer version is connected at the chamber, the Prior Lake Chamber of Commerce. You can get to it there or on our website or on our YouTube channel. We've submitted our 1 minute video now to Scott County, to the company that's doing their whole website design, where we are going to be one of the highlighted icons. And if you push on that icon or click on that, then you will see this 1 minute video of our district promotional video. So that's all completed, and now we're working on the high school short video of what happens at the high school. We'll also do one for the middle school and one for elementary, so that parents that want to, that are surfing the net and want to know about our district but want to know specifically about what happens for their child at that level will have that opportunity. So we're finishing those up now with Don Shelby doing the voiceover. A lot of the timing of this is his availability. And you probably have seen him in the press recently. He's doing a lot of different kinds of things right now, but he's also been doing the voiceovers for our promotional videos. We're very excited about that. Last week, I attended a superintendent summit with Apple Technology to talk about the future of technology and education, where that's going, where we are, how people learn, how students are learning differently, and there's some opportunities coming up in the next couple of weeks where staff will be visiting schools in our area to look at different ways that technology is being used to enhance our student learning. This week, today, we started our Strive partnership with the Prior Lake Rotary. They're bringing in adult volunteers to be mentors for students at Bridges. There will be about 15 students at Bridges paired up with an adult mentor throughout the school year. So we had our adult orientation this morning, and on Thursday at noon we'll be having lunch over at Bridges with the students that have been that have volunteered and been selected to participate in this first year. If the students participate and are able to raise their grade point average, they will qualify for a $300 scholarship to a post-secondary institution, and then one student will receive a $600 scholarship to a post-secondary institution as a result of their work this year with their mentor. So we're very excited about this happening. For years we've had the Optimus Club Excel program at the high school, and now that we have our own Bridges, to have mentoring by community members that live right here in our community that are willing to go in and work with our students and be adult listeners and role models for them is really good work. So we're very excited about this beginning that's going to be starting this week. And as I mentioned previously, I am visiting schools. I was in Mr. Knapp's AP physics class last week, learning about the velocity and height and distance of marble as it catapults off of the third story of the high school balcony and the projections. And I was amazed by the ability of the students to graph the charts, make the right formulas in order to complete the task at hand, and I'm looking forward to returning. That was really fun. I visited Nicole McMahon's fax class at Twin Oaks one day. Tomorrow I'm going to be at Glendale, and on Friday at Jeffers Pond visiting with staff, elementary staff, about the new science curriculum, the impact of RTI, that response to intervention, and now that we're getting into our second and third year, depending on the grade level, what that's looking like, and certainly for our fourth and fifth graders as they look at it with math and just beginning it, and also the impact that technology is having on students at the elementary level. And then the benefits and whatever I can bring to them is certainly what support I can give them as we move through this year. At the middle and second high school level, I have different questions, of course, much around the six period day and the transitions there. But I've developed questions and then sending them out a week before so our staff members have time to think about them, and then we can have some conversations and dialogue during their lunchtime. So I'll be at each of these schools from 11:15 to about 1 during this week, and over the course of the next several weeks I'll be in all the schools. And then on invitations that keep coming this Friday, I'm also visiting Tom Hassig's choir, men's choir rehearsal before their October 31st big event coming up next week. And that's it.
Okay. Any other administrative reports? Okay. Any board reports?
I think, you know, one of the, obviously our modified agenda item covered one of the things that we discussed in the Finance Committee tonight. The reason that we had brought that tonight was in order to get it out formally so that at the meet and confer, we would be able to discuss that with the teachers. However, Julie did bring another item to the Finance Committee that we talked about tonight that will be coming to the next board meeting, and that is a new accounts payable pricing program that will give the district an opportunity to save, you know, $40,000 to $50,000, $60,000 a year, and basically just moving our payables from, you know, one path, if you will, to another. So we've asked Julie to look if there's other options out there. You know, that's sort of our policy, I guess, that we try to get more than one source. And so I think that's mainly the reason why we haven't brought it forward tonight, is to give Julie an opportunity to see if there's anybody else that offers a similar program so that we would be able to compare different options. So we're expecting that at the November 14th meeting, we should have that formally to bring to the board.
Any other board reports? I'll just mention for the board that we've got Certified Committee has meet and confer on Wednesday, and Building Committee is meeting Thursday at 5.
You know what, I should another. Tom and I were in the District Curriculum Advisory Committee meeting today as well, and so there's a new course that through the Project Lead the Way program will be coming forward. I don't know if it'll be at the next board meeting or after that, but essentially it's a civil engineering and architecture class that I think there's a lot of excitement. The committee was, I think, very supportive of it, and so we're eagerly looking forward to that. And then also we got a little bit of an overview of a planned study to look at the valedictorian salutatorian program that Mr. Lund and Mr. Palucki are looking to get underway here in the next couple of months or so.
Anything else? Okay, before we move into closed session to talk about negotiations, I'd just like to touch on some of the upcoming events we have. The Community Education Halloween Party at Twin Oaks Middle School, 2:30 to 5 tomorrow?
Saturday.
Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
The early release again on November 2nd, with the end of the first quarter on November 10th. No school on the 11th then. And then our next regular board meeting on the 14th. I thought I'd just bring up, you know, this is a fun time in activities as well. We've got boys football playing on Tuesday, hosting a sections meet or sections game. Volleyball hosting a sections meet on Wednesday. And then I know we've got cross-country sections are going on as well for both boys and girls, and some adapted soccer varsity games. So
tonight, 9 to 3.
9 to 3?
One.
Awesome. And then another one on Wednesday, right?
Thank you, Lisa.
So before we move into closed session, is there any other business that needs to come before the board? Okay. Seeing none, I will take a motion to move into closed session.
So moved.
By Tom.
Second.
By Tom. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay, we'll move into closed session. We'll take a 5-minute recess and reconvene at 8 o'clock.
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Second.
Aye.
Aye.